I just sniffed the air. But anyway, incentives are very important. It's important to know the motivation for success. You see, I can do anything without being incentivized to do it, but it's not going to be done very well. It's only going to be done well most of the time if I have a good long-term incentive for it. You see, it doesn't take a lot of incentive to give money to some homeless guy. Most people would do this, actually. Especially in New York, where panhandling is becoming a bit more of a big deal and more problematic. Especially around public transportation, where people are coming in, coming out, and they're not going to think about it too heavily. Panhandling has its role over there. They're not even panhandling subway trains. I mentioned this in September, my hatred of panhandlers. Yet, again, we're not really helping them when we give them money. We're not. It's short-term, and we're not incentivized in the first place to actually help them out. So, this should be obvious. And incentives work in a lot of other situations. I'm not going to look at it from a business perspective. I'm just going to look at it purely in an economic level, with some politics drawn together and some ethno elements put into that. But for starters, what a typical monarchist would say is that monarchy is better because the ruler is going to be there for a long term, not just 4 years or 1 year, if we don't think of it even way more back in a Roman perspective. So he's going to have more of a reason to want the place to be better for the long term, for the nation, the country, the city, the province, to look healthier in the long term, since he's going to be in it for the long run, maybe even his kids or his successors. He doesn't want to give them a difficult time. And because of that, he really wants to get rid of the filth and the infestation and make sure that the place gets cleaned up on a periodic basis, that there is a means of brainwashing people to do good and to not degenerate. And by degenerate, he means he doesn't want the place to go from Detroit 1950s to Detroit 2010s, that decade. He wants to keep it at a workable level, at a pragmatic level. Now again, incentives also play a role in nationalism, or not even nationalism, just the people you want around. You want the people around to be the guys that are going to be here in the long haul, the guys that feel a connection to the land. And that's a problem with the heavy immigration, because if you're going to have third worlders come in that frequently come back to their home place, do you think they're going to be incentivized to worry about the geopolitical conditions of your area? No. If it gets too bad in the United States, they're going to go back to Haiti, DR, their islands, their backwater continent. It doesn't matter. They don't have an incentive. Jews don't have an incentive to do good for the United States in the long haul, or said first world nation or second world place with potential, they don't have that motive. Because they've never been connected to a land and to a people. And because of that, it becomes a bit of a problem. Now, of course, there are exceptions, but those exceptions are fucking obvious, and if you don't get them, you're fucking stupid. People that really do see themselves as being there in the long haul are going to be incentivized to make sure the place is clean, to make sure the place is healthy, to make sure that it's going to be a home for them, their descendants, the people they care about for the long run. Because it's something to worry about. There's a motivation to do good for that environment. And if they're disconnected from it, then what's going to be the incentive for them to do good? Nothing. They might have their fantasies that are going to benefit them or work purely on an altruistic level, yet they're not going to work for a long-term good. Maybe a short-term good, but not a long-term good. That's why when I see these third worlders voting liberal, I'm thinking, well, what'd you expect? What the fuck did you expect? Because these people estimate back to their hometowns or home cities or home countries on a regular periodic basis. They have no incentive for the betterment of their land, for the betterment of the people around them when they're here. So what's the point? They have no reason to care. Or when I see the subversion Jews engage on a city basis, on places they like, hang around in places they like, just playing experimental games with, they're gonna do it because where's their home? Okay, they finally have a home now, in a way they have Israel, but I don't see them utilizing it properly. The people that are in Israel, quite frankly, aren't the problematic people, they're just some brownies, that's it. And a couple of other people, I'm not going to play the data game. But you see the point. Incentives matter. This should be redundant, it is redundant, I'm just making a video to make a video, but it works in the fact that I don't get triggered when I see people engaging in stupidity and political subversions and voting liberal or doing things of this nature when they are a third worlder or a Jew, because what's the motivation? They don't have a motivation to do good. They barely even care for their home place as much as they want to front them. Because there's no reason for them to worry about the long term. The only thing they care about is the individual material gains and things of that nature, because that you can take anywhere. You can't cultivate that. You can extract that from various resources with some hard work or some persistency or some time that you put in, but it's not something that you can put day-to-day effort on and struggle. You're not gonna see the spoilers that you get and go, look what I did with this, look at all the work I put in. that's all I gotta say is Mr. Wonka 7 and Respect the King.